The movement right now is that they want to block black sheriff. That's the social movement, social media movement.
So this is why we stop playing foreign music, and this is what gave birth to what is Afrobeat today. Dr. Dopeti called us one day and said,
"Hello, welcome to my channel once again. Welcome. I'm asking some Nigerians some questions today. I don't know whether it's an agenda against Ghana or Ghanaian musicians or what. I don't even understand. Perhaps some Nigerians don't understand English or simple English. That's what I will say. Trust me, because the agenda you guys are setting is totally off.
The movement right now is that they want to block black sheriff. That's the social movement, social media movement. But it's impossible.
Why would they want to block?
Don't mind the bloggers. It's the bloggers that try to insinuate that.
First of all, what at all did Blasher you see? He didn't say anything wrong.
My brother.
He even mentioned this morning. I was watching it again.
Yeah.
He said that this is no time for blame games. We're not blaming DJs. We're not blaming the consumers. We're not blaming the musicians. All we're saying is that make it a fair ground for people so we can simply.
You are in the media. And you know that certain media platforms and personalities love agenda. And there is no better agenda than to create something that didn't exist. That image that we spoke about, Reggie Rockstone and OG, Samini and OG, Small God and OG. You know, these are OGs that we're talking.
DJ Mensa was
Mensa, standing right next to them. Right. Is an OG representing Sarkode and... And then you have a young artist in Black Sheriff there. Who do you think haters and bloggers will want to pick? Do you think they will attack Small God? Or they will talk to Reggie Rockstone? Do you think you can say anything to somebody like that? Or Samini? No. They're going to go for the baby. Who really has just started his career. He's just building relationships. And they can tell that he's still, you know, wet behind the ears. Let's target this one. He won't be able to fight back. Reggie Rockstone can jump on IG Live now and tell you about yourself. Samini can do the same thing. But our brother Black Sheriff is still young. And remember, Nigeria has become Black Sheriff territory, where some fan bases might not even be happy about that. The love he gets in Nigeria, you can't even understand. Black Sheriff, I use Black Sheriff as an example to other Ghanaian artists. They love Black Sheriff gets more love in Nigeria than some Nigerian artists. So, of course, they're going to want to attack the popular person currently in that market. He didn't say anything wrong. There was nothing wrong about that whole conversation. Even not only what each individual was saying, the entire conversation. Local content deserves to be supported. Ghana has become a huge destination for foreigners. Every December, when we come here, we take home whatever it is that we hear. If local content isn't promoted, then whatever we hear from here is what we're going to go and promote in UK and America.
And it's disgusting. Listen, we are all in this African continent. We are trying to help one another, you understand? But I'm in my country and I feel like I have a product that another country also has the same product, but my people in my country are buying that foreign product. What is the problem if I tell my people to patronize what I am producing, the same thing that they are buying from outside? If I tell them to patronize what I am also producing, what is wrong with that? I just want to know. So Small God was on Twitter some few days ago and he said he went to the club. He went to a club with Stoneboy and Medical. They were at the club from 1 a.m. to 5:30 a.m. And Ghanaian songs that were played were only 5. Imagine being in a club in Ghana or not even outside Ghana. That would have been something normal, you understand? But we are in Ghana. And this is like the December festivities, going to a club and just hearing 5 Ghanaian songs from 1 a.m. to 5:30 a.m. If this thing happens in Nigeria, This is a question that I'm asking. Won't Nigerians be mad that why are our DJs not playing our songs? And these people decided to push forward and go to the ministry to plead that they should come out and do what? Help them advocate to Ghanaians and Ghanaian DJs that, hey, please, we are in Ghana and we are in the December festivities. It is all right for you to be a patriotic citizen. As a DJ, please play more Ghanaian songs. What is so wrong or what is so bad about this? And you are seeing Nigerian blogs twisting the whole thing and turning the blame or pushing the blame onto Black Sherif. What did even Black Sherif say? Let me play you the video.
Blessings to everybody. You see, with me, everything I say is brief and short and heartfelt. You know, this is not a blame game. We are not blaming DJs, we are not blaming artists, we are not blaming consumers. It's a step in the right direction for us all and our music and our culture. So play Ghana. Blessings.
So listen, this is what Black Sherif said. Listening to him, where in his speech did he even say they should ban foreign music? Who said they should ban? You know, some Nigerians sometimes, immediately Ghanaians start advocating for something like that. They think they are the target. In recent times, let's be honest, if you are someone who listens to a lot of music, Afrobeat has even gone down a bit. It is Amapiano that is up, like people are playing Amapiano everywhere. It is not even Afrobeat. So why are you guys, like, I don't understand. Is this witchcraft or something? Like, tell me, I don't know if this is witchcraft, because the way you guys are carrying, when you go to some of these blogs and their comment section, some comments that are coming from some Nigerians, is just disgusting, man. Not long ago, there is a video, one legendary Nigerian journalist, he made a video talking about how foreign music took over in Nigeria. And some of the Nigerian gatekeepers went and asked some of the Nigerian presenters that they should look at their playlist. Who is number one? Who is number two? Who is number three? And all these guys were foreigners. So they took that challenge upon themselves to advocate and make sure Nigerian songs were played. Almost every Nigerian, like when you enter Nigeria, you should hear Nigerian songs. This was something conscious that the Nigerian gatekeepers, some of them, took upon themselves and did to change the narrative. And you, today you are hearing Nigerian songs everywhere.
This is why we stopped playing foreign music. And this is what gave birth to what is Afrobeat today. Dr. Dupeti called us one day and said, now we're done. What's number one on your top 10? It was Tupac. What's number two? Whitney Houston. Number top, everything was foreign. So you people don't see any Nigerian that. We say, it's only King Sonny and the Shina Peters. They don't, their music is not popular, sir. Say, now we're done. So how long will you keep doing that? When has Michael Jackson ever called to say thank you for making me number one? Why don't you look for some local boys, promote them, make them superstars? People will see them on the street and say, So don't forget this. Because when you are on the stage jumping and your fans are screaming, they are the ones that are playing your music. When you are not there, you are sleeping, they are playing it at midnight, Friday, Saturday. This is the hottest thing. But people now forget because your music is now trending everywhere. But if these ones don't play it and start and light that fire, your talent will just be in your head, you'll be playing in your bedroom. So don't forget them.
In addition to what he said, Skills and Zeal, they just came from London, from airport here.
They landed,
enter car, through radio to get his FM.
It's Vibration, they were playing his music.
Vibration.
Wow. Yes, he filmed it.
Wow.
It was Kelly's FM, long play. Vibration.
Massive.
And they played from the beginning to the end.
So what is the problem if Ghana takes the same step to do the same thing? Why? Like, what is wrong? And you guys are just... Listen, Black Sherif is blessed. And that guy, no matter what you do, that guy will still shine. It is not only Nigerians that listen to him. So you guys should stop this hypocrisy. This is hypocrisy, trust me. It is not every Nigerian. I know it is not every Nigerian who is supporting this, because I've seen BlackBones drop some tweet explaining what actually Black Sherif and Samini and all the other guys said. And Adesope, also, he was in Ghana. He also said something similar.
It's funny that today of all days, when I touched down Ghana, is when some people want to twist the narrative that Nigerians want to cancel certain musicians from Ghana who's requesting for more support from their media platforms. I think people need to listen carefully before we start just criticizing people. Blogs and bloggers will run with their own narratives for traction, but as human beings, we need to pay more attention to the words spoken by people and don't go just by clickbait and headlines. Nobody said to stop Nigerian music in Ghana. They only asked for more support for local content, which is right.
You know, so I know that there are a lot of Nigerians that are actually in support or don't have a problem with what Ghana or Ghanaians are deciding to do. It is just some few bloggers that I don't know what they want, and some people. Listen, how can you be in a country and you go to a club and that particular country, we have a lot of songs, and the DJ will decide to play just five songs for about within 5 hours. Play just five songs. Like, seriously, bro. Like, tell me, won't you be upset? Let's stop this hypocrisy, Charlie. Let's just stop it. Stop it. Listen, we are going to play Ghana music, and I know that this advocacy will go a longer way to help so that they play more Ghana music. It is just right for you to be in Ghana and you'll be hearing Ghanaian songs. That's all. And nothing is wrong. Thank you so much for watching.